Every time I've had to use Windows since I made the switch to Linux, I've found myself incredibly frustrated. The experience is subpar, to say the least. It's a legacy operating system on life support that's still being shoved down everyone's throats simply because its predecessors cemented themselves as defaults for business infrastructure and home computing way back in the 90s. The fact is, the only appeal Windows has is its support for Windows applications, stuff like games and maybe Adobe products. But in my opinion, Windows is a dead platform that hasn't truly innovated since at least 2001. So when I read about how Microsoft is moving away from legacy support with a modern version of Windows called Windows Core OS, I couldn't help but smile. This will be the final nail in Microsoft's coffin. But I'm getting ahead of myself. Let's talk about what Windows Core OS actually is. According to WindowsCentral.com, Windows Core OS is a modular, modern take on the Windows operating system that aims to leave behind legacy components. That's Win32 support if you don't know. With the stated purpose of a more performant and power-conscious system. The problem is that people who use Windows aren't using it because they want a modern or performant OS. They use it because that's where the games and software they rely on get published. And the vast majority of that software comes from outside the Windows store. There aren't many Windows fans, after all. Now, some might say, but Gardiner, this is not going to replace Windows 10. We'll still have Windows 10 for gaming. Except that Microsoft has, historically, been reckless, impulsive, and so far up their own ass with decision-making that I can easily see this becoming a mandatory update for all Windows 10 users. You might think I'm crazy, but I really don't think so. Rather, I would style myself as an optimist. You see, Microsoft has always been the kind of company that has no self-control. They see an opportunity like this, and they take it. They'll jump headlong into this without taking into consideration the fact that it's one of the worst ideas they've had since Microsoft Bob. So how does all this tie in with Linux? Well, dropping legacy support and imposing a Windows Store distribution model will be the spur that drives more people away from their closed, proprietary, and dead ecosystem. And the alternative? It's Linux distros with increasingly powerful tools like Wine, virtualization, and native applications that are starting to seriously compete with proprietary offerings. The future is free. Proprietary operating systems are a thing of the past. We will win, in spite of menacing corporate dominance and vendor lock-in schemes, and I wouldn't have it any other way. But what do you think? Does Windows Core OS sign Microsoft's death warrant? Leave me a comment and let me know down below, or on Twitter, @TheLinuxGamer. If you appreciate the work that I do, you can support this channel with a monthly contribution over on Patreon, and now LibrePay, the free and open source alternative. You can also like this video and share it with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to see more from me, The Linux Gamer. And as always, thanks for watching.